Hi everyone, welcome to this video where we are going to be talking about the whiteboard and the calculator that you will see inside your exam. We received a lot of questions about this during our recent Ncarb Live, so we are here today to answer some of the questions we didn't have time for during the Ncarb Live. So Nick, what is the first question that we have today?
Great, thanks Michelle. So first question that we have is, will adding a lot of whiteboard pages slow down the exam's loading time? Ncarb actually did extensive testing before we released the whiteboard to the demonstration exam. And the answer to that is no. We have successfully added hundreds of pages to the whiteboard, and we have not witnessed any slowdown in performance. So our recommendation for you all would be to add as many pages as you need to successfully answer your questions on your ARE division.
Great. Our next question, am I required to use the whiteboard during my exam if I don't need to? Not at all. It is a tool that is there for you to use if you need it during your exam. If you don't need the whiteboard, you can just leave it closed the whole time and just make your way through your test questions.
Next question, Ncarb has already said candidates will still see previously entered whiteboard content after a break, but will they be able to edit that content? The answer is yes. So if you are taking an exam and let's say you filled 15 pages with exam notes and content, calculations, whatever it is, and then you go on break, when you return from that break, all of that whiteboard content will still be available to you. And you can also go in and you can edit that as well. So it will be saved and editable following a break.
Our next question. When I practiced the demo exam, the whiteboard crashed and my content was erased. How will this be handled if it happens during an actual exam? Will the time lost be replaced? So we have done extensive testing of the whiteboard, as Nick was mentioning, and we don't expect this to occur during any exam administrations. So if you do experience a technical issue during your exam, just as always, it's really important for you to report that to the Prometric proctor during your exam administration. So just like if you were in the test center, if you're in an online proctored exam as well, you want to make sure that you report the issue while it's happening. And then also following your exam administration, you'll want to contact Ncarb to also let us know what happened so we can investigate it.
Great, so next question. Currently, the text on the whiteboard is very hard to reselect. Will this be fixed by December 14th? So we assume you're talking about you're using the whiteboard during your exam, you've added a text box, you've added some content into that text box, maybe you're answering your question, you realize, oh, I need to go back and add something else to that, and you're trying to reselect that content. You actually can, so to do that, you wanna click first on the text box. So what it's going to do, it's gonna highlight the outside of it. That won't allow you to edit it yet. Then you'll need to click again inside of the box, and that will open up the editing ability where you can add additional info into that text box. Now, if you're struggling with doing that, our recommendation would be to just add an additional text box. It's unlimited to the number you add. So if you have, 15, 16 text boxes within one page on your whiteboard, that's totally fine, not an issue.
Our next question, have you considered adding a history function to the calculator? Well, in fact, the calculator does have a memory function already. So if you want to save a value, you can click on the store to memory button on the calculator. One thing that's important to remember on that is that when you then move to the next item in your exam, that calculator memory is reset. So you are not able to store things from one item to the next, but certainly while you're working on one particular item, you can absolutely store information in that memory. Just again, click that store to memory button.
Next question, will we be able to type in different languages within the whiteboard? The current whiteboard is designed for an English-based keyboard only, so that's what you'll need to use for the ARE.
Right, we have received a number of questions here asking about some potential enhancements to the whiteboard. We received such questions as, will Ncarb add an undo button to the whiteboard? Can you rename pages or tabs within the whiteboard? Can you link pages in the whiteboard to a specific exam question? Will Ncarb consider embedding the calculator into the whiteboard? And can I keep using the same tool on the whiteboard without clicking the tool button every time? So those are all great comments there. And I can tell you that in my weekly discussions with the development team behind the whiteboard, We do talk about potential future enhancements in addition to just the day-to-day kind of operations. So these can certainly be added to that list to look at again in the future as we continue to use the whiteboard. As we make any updates, we will certainly let the candidate community know about them.
And our last question here today, Michelle, is about calculations using the whiteboard. So the question is, can Ncarb demonstrate the best way to complete a complex calculation using the whiteboard? First, I want to reinforce to all testers that this is not an algebra exam, nor is it meant to be an algebra exam. This is an architecture licensing exam, but there are going to be some calculation questions that you will encounter across all six divisions of the ARE. Now, those questions, those number of calculation questions make up a very small percentage of the overall items you will see within each division. And if you're curious the types of calculation questions you'll be asked, open up and go to the ARE 5.0 handbook. And there are a bunch of different calculation questions within that resource that really illustrate the types of calculations that you'll be asked as part of the exam. And I have one of those items here today, and I'm gonna go ahead and share it and demonstrate how I would solve this. Now, this is an item you'll notice at face value, you might not think this is a calculation item. There's no formula that's included as part of it. You don't see an exhibit with a series of formulas located there. But what you'll see is this is an item that talks about a construction phase owner request change that requires an addition of 10 footings. This is a simple calculation question of additional footing cubic feet with changes to the overall project cost. So I'm going to walk you through how a candidate should answer this question using the whiteboard. So the first thing you'd want to do is open up the whiteboard on your screen. You'll see it here. And you want to make sure you're sizing the whiteboard so it's not covering up any of the content of the item. So I'm going to go ahead and make this whiteboard a little bit bigger. Now, since I know this is a calculation item, I'm also going to open up the calculator on the screen. And I'm going to locate that over here to the left, because I'm going to have to navigate between the whiteboard and calculator throughout this calculation. So the first thing, by looking at this item, that I'm going to need to note that this change is requiring 10 additional footings. Now, for me as a tester, I'm just going to note that 10 additional footings. That's a note for me that I know that's what I'm looking for. Now next, I can see from this first line that each footing size is 4.5 feet by 4.5 feet by 36 feet. So that's my first calculation that I'm going to be doing as a part of this item. So I'm gonna go down here. I'm gonna add a new text box because I'm not gonna add to the previous note that I had about 10 additional footings. So in this note, I know I'm gonna have to take 4.5. I'm gonna multiply that by 4.5. And then I'm going to multiply that by 10. Since we know we have 10, actually, I'm gonna step back here, by 36. And then we know we have 10 footings. So I'm also gonna multiply that by 10. Drop a space over here so it's clear. And so that's my first calculation. Now I'm gonna go over to my calculator. I'm gonna click on it and let's do a quick calculation here. 4.5 times 4.5 times 36, and then finally times 10. Okay, so we have a value here. I'm gonna click on my text box over here. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put an equal sign, and I know I have 7,290. Now, units are really important in this item. So what units am I working with currently? It's cubic feet. So I'm gonna put a note that I'm working with cubic feet here. So that's the first part of this question. Now, for the material costs, the crew labor, and then finally the miscellaneous equipment costs, you'll notice that all these are in cubic feet, or this is in cubic yards, excuse me, not cubic feet. So what I'm going to need to do is I need to convert that 7,290 cubic feet to cubic yards. So I'm gonna add another text box because this is how I prefer to work in the whiteboard. So we'll say take 7,290 cubic feet, and we are going to divide that by, I happen to know that there are 27 cubic feet within a cubic yard. So we're gonna divide this by 27. I'm gonna drop an equals in here. Now I'm gonna jump back over to my calculator. I already have the 7,290 in my calculator. So I'm just gonna hit the divide symbol here and we'll divide by 27. And that's gonna tell me that there are 270 cubic yards that we're actually talking about here. So I'm gonna drop that in here. Okay. Now I know, and I'm gonna take that and I'm gonna bold that just so I can reinforce this to me that that's the amount of concrete that we're talking about in this change to this project. Now I need to take that 270. I'm gonna add another text box here. Since I know it's 270 cubic yards, I'm gonna have to then take that and I'm gonna multiply it. So I'm gonna drop that in. Now, what I wanna multiply it is the cost per cubic yard. So looking over at the question again, it looks like the cost for crew labor is 175, the cost for the material cost 225, and then finally we have a miscellaneous cost of $3. And actually, I'm gonna break this equation up and I'm gonna just let that 270 sit here for a moment. And let's add up what the total cost per cubic yard is. So 175, on top of that, we're gonna add 225 for material costs. And then finally, we have $3 per cubic yard for miscellaneous equipment. So we'll add that three here. We'll put equals, we're gonna jump over to the calculator. If you're really good at addition, you can go ahead and do this without the calculator, but I'm gonna demonstrate using the calculator here. Plus 225. Plus three, that leaves 403 is what we're looking at for the cost per cubic yard. So I'm gonna jump back over to my whiteboard, 403. This is a dollar value. So I'm going to add a dollar sign in here so I know. Now I know the cost per cubic yard. I know the total number of cubic yards that I need. So I'm gonna jump back over to this 270. We're gonna multiply that by $403 equals. Let's jump back over to my calculator. We're going to times that 430 by 270. And it looks like the total cost is going to be $108,810. That's in dollars. I'm going to go back and I'm actually going to add a dollar sign in here so I know. Okay. Then it looks like there's a final line in this item that asks for the contractor's overhead and profit being 10%. So now that I have $108,810, I know that I'm gonna have to multiply this by 1.1 to make up that 10% addition for the contractor's overhead. So let's go back over to my calculator. Let's times this by 1.1. It's gonna give us a total of $119,691. Okay, so I've completed all my calculations. Now I'm gonna go back and figure out what exactly does the item wanna know. And it says here in the stem, how much over budget will this request change place the project? Round to the nearest whole dollar. Well, I know this change is gonna cost $119,691. I can see here in the question that the current construction cost is $9,900,000. So if I add this $119,691 to the $9,900,000, I'm gonna be based on a construction budget of $10 million, I'm gonna be a total of $19,691 over the budget. Now, what you can see from me going through this question is I didn't try to outline this as one giant formula. Instead, I added several different text boxes to solve this. Some you might look at and say, well, they look a little bit incomplete. The good news in all of this is Ncarb isn't going to see what's on your whiteboard. I'm not gonna see it, Michelle's not gonna see it. What really matters is you're using the whiteboard to answer the item correctly, and you can do it in any manner that you wish. Now, I will say I chose to use the draw a text option while I was solving this. That's the best way to do calculations. If you try to sketch them out using the pencil, you're going to find it very frustrating and time consuming. So recommend doing any calculations using the draw text function.
All right. Well, Nick, thank you so much for walking us through that. That was really helpful. I hope that our candidates found that to be really helpful. And I hope all the other information we presented in this video was really helpful to you. So be sure to watch our other videos for other questions. Again, covering additional content beyond what we discussed in the Ncarb Live. And best of luck in your exams.